After you have done setting up the IP address and setting up the remote desktop connections, so what I am going to do is I am going to install TeamViewer on all of these computers. So if I have some sort of a problem, I can, you know, just connect them remotely. So I'm going to download TeamViewer and I am going to install it on all of these machines. So the installation process of installing the TeamViewer is pretty simple. Just click on next, and you want to be creating an account for the TeamViewer. You can use the free version. I use this for, you know, by the way, this username and password, it changes every time you boot up your computer or the TeamViewer starts. I am going to, you know, log in through my username and password. So the software installation part is time-consuming process. So what you want to be doing is, you know, like doing this in phases. Like in phase one, you want to be categorizing your installation, like installing the TeamViewer, installing the antivirus, installing the browser, like Windows related tasks. So the task that needs to be done first. So after you have done installing the softwares for Windows related, like I wrote down here, you can move to the next phase, which is like installing 3ds Max, installing Maya, installing V-Ray, installing Corona, installing Arnold Renderer, installing Cinema 4D, whatever software you use. You want to be installing in the phase 2, and it should be named phase 2, not phase 1. So if you do it in phases, it can be easier. And remember, I told you that I have a ledger, a book, a log for myself. I wrote down all of these tasks that I do in phases. I write them down, so it will be easier to, you know, do everything on all of these machines, because it will be very easy to forget one step. So remember, we are not setting this up on one computer, we are setting this up on five machines, and not to mention one laptop.